made it through security and they asked me about my chicken and rice, of course, because I put it in a bag and I froze it the night before so that I could bring a whole bunch of chicken and rice to Toronto with me. And they were like, I heard the bell go off and they were like, there's a bag of food in here. I'm like, oh my god. But made it through security and now I'm just waiting for my flight and here's my ticket and I'm very excited and this feels very surreal. So yeah, I have about 25 minutes until they start boarding and I'm meeting Josh in Toronto. He arrives at 1 in the morning, so he'll be arriving after me, and then we're getting the same flight home. So this is all very new and it feels very interesting to be doing this, and I can't believe I'm about to get on an actual flight and go across the country. Pretty good gig.
You're living the dream kind of thing.
Yeah.
And that's not inexpensive to put you on the business class either. So, I mean, that's...
I know. I was like, wow, I've never gotten an iPad on a flight before. I've only ever flown twice in my life.
Yeah.
One to Winnipeg and then one to Mexico City when I was like 8.
Yeah.
I threw up and passed out on the plane from food poisoning, so...
Well, you did much better.
Yeah, it was a little weird when it was going down. My ears kept popping, and
yeah.
It's a little bit freaky.
I got to go to the US, but you're going straight.
All right, thank you so much. It was nice meeting you.
Yeah.
Well, I'm in Toronto, and I need to find my bags. And I met a nice man on the plane, and he helps me. And apparently there's going to be somebody waiting for me with a sign, because I don't know where I'm going. Okay, so this is baggage, and... I guess I just have to wait for my bag. My mom put a bunch of like pink stickers on my bag, so should be relatively easy to find. Yeah, isn't there supposed to be rain on Saturday? It's supposed to, like, the temperature is supposed to drop and it's supposed to be like 9 degrees here.
Yes.
But today it's 27.
Yes.
Yeah, I'm sweating. It kind of reminds me of downtown Vancouver.
Oh, okay.
Have you been there before?
Yeah, I've been there, yeah.
Yeah,
because
that's...
I love their Stanley Park. I've been over there for a few times. It's a beautiful, park, I guess.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, no, this is definitely much bigger than Vancouver.
Nice.
But it reminds me of Vancouver, because I guess Vancouver is the biggest place that I've ever been.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
So what sports you play or something like that?
I compete in bodybuilding competitions, so you know, like the Olympia, how the bikini girls go on stage.
Oh, that kind of thing. Oh, okay.
Yeah, that's what I do, but I'm not at the Olympia level yet.
Okay.
But hopefully one day.
Yeah.
Yeah, you walk down and we'll go find some sushi and poke.
Are you actually going to do that?
Did you say poke?
Poke.
Poke.
We'll clean that last our heads.
Walking that way?
Yeah, we'll go straight.
Alright.
Bye.
Catch you guys in a bit. I'll ring you when I chop these guys up. Bye.
Yeah.
I'm sorry, how do you say your name again?
Ajot! Jawsy.
Jawsy. This is a Jawsy. This is Sam. We're gonna go find sushi somewhere because apparently there's some place to eat like every 10 feet here in Toronto. So.
Five feet.
This is so cool.
One already.
Yep, one already. What is Zanzibar?
Zanzibar is a strip club.
Is it actually?
Genuinely, yeah.
Oh my god.
Naked dancers.
It's a strip club.
No cover. I don't quite know what that means, but I
don't. You don't have to pay to get in.
Well, wait.
Cover charge. To get in.
I could technically get in there because I'm of age.
Walk through the door, they'll say like, well, oh, it's a $10 cover pay. No, they do that at regular bars. I don't even have Canadian money.
Oh my god, is that Jim Halpert?
It is Jim.
No way!
You got ripped.
Alright, so we're at some poke place. I got zucchini noodles and tuna and vegetables because trying to maintain macros, but it's really not working out. And then a Jawsy got
everything.
Alright, guys, I just got in my hotel. I'm on the 18th floor, and apparently, this is the biggest hotel in Canada. So, pretty cool. I met Demi Bagby in the hotel lobby, and I met Sam. He's with Gymshark, and wow, just I can't believe I'm finally here. I made it. I'm here. Oh my god. You guys, this is absolutely incredible, and I am so grateful to be here. This is so big, and I'm gonna get emotional, you guys, and just this is honestly such a blessing, and I don't know what to make of it, and I feel so happy that I'm actually gonna start crying pretty soon. Okay, but I'm not gonna cry because I'm happy. Okay, so first thing I'm noticing is there's no fridge in here, so my chicken and rice that's in my bag is probably gonna go bad, but that's fine because Sam was like, let me know if you wanna go for food, so we're probably gonna go get... I told him I wanted sushi and he was like, that's actually the only food I don't like, so we'll figure it out, but this is like a dream. You know what, this is like so crazy to think that there is so much world out there and there is so much for me to see, and this is all because of who I am and my story and people. I just love you guys so much. I'm so overwhelmed. I have so much to say. I'm excited to meet everyone. I'm gonna meet Chris Bumstead. I'm gonna meet Nikki Blackadder, Whitney Simmons. And we're all part of the same family. We're all part of the Gymshark family, and now, like, I'm part of that family, and that is so incredible. And my throat is so tight because I'm actually about to start getting like hella emotional. So I just wanted to share that with you guys. Let me check out the bathroom. Actually, the bathroom is always something that I need to see. Okay, it's not that bad. It's not that bad, but okay, so there will be lots of vlogging, and I'm so excited to share this with you guys. And you guys know, like, you've been with me since day one, so I feel like this is just the beginning for everything. I love you guys so much.